Hello students,
in our topic projectile motion we have covered case number first, that was projectile thrown horizontally, and now today we are understanding the second case in which projectile is thrown at some angle theta with horizontal. Okay, so let us understand with the help of this diagram that how this projectile is thrown and what type of shape or what type of path it is going to cover. So whenever we throw any object at some angle theta, so we can say that the initial velocity which is given, that is u, but this u is now not along x-axis or y-axis, that means horizontal or vertical, it is in between at some angle theta. So suppose if I call horizontal direction x direction and vertical direction y axis. So now what is happening? One object is thrown at some angle, okay, at some angle theta with horizontal. So what will happen? Suppose a stone we throw at some angle with the horizontal, then what will happen? The stone will go upwards and it will reach the highest point, but after some time it is going to return back to earth. So that means if we complete the path of the projectile, it is like this. Okay, it will be both sides similar. So this type of path will be of the projectile, or we can call it that this is the parabolic shape. Okay, now here in this diagram we are going to understand some parameters which are related to this projectile case, which is at some angle case. So first of all, the object, from the point from which the object is thrown and the point where it is falling down or reaches back to earth or the ground, that distance between these two points, this distance is called the horizontal range R. Okay, this we call horizontal range. We are going to get the derivation, and using that derivation we are going to solve the horizontal range formula. In the same manner, the height or the highest point where the object will reach, that highest point, this distance is called the vertical height or maximum height h. Okay, so what do we name it? We may name it maximum height covered by the object. So we are going to calculate h also. After that, now the total time of the journey, okay, we will call it time of flight. Time of flight. So we will call it capital T. Okay, so total time from the starting of the journey and where it ends, whatever time total is taken by that projectile, that total time we call time of flight. Now you can see the similarity of this type of the projectile and this side of the projectile, this side and this side, they are similar. That means this time we can call the time of ascent. Okay, time taken by the object to from the starting point to the highest point, suppose I name it A. So time taken by the object to reach from O to A, this is called time of ascent. Okay, in the same manner, from the highest point, whatever time is taken to reach the ground, suppose it is B point. So here whatever time is taken, that we call time of descent. Okay, now time of ascent and time of descent are same, using the equations of motion. So if total time of the journey is capital T, so time of ascent is T by 2 and time of descent is also T by 2. Okay, so these are the parameters which we are going to calculate using this initial velocity. So let us understand now the components of this initial velocity here. Then we are proceeding in the next sheet with the help of calculations of all these main parameters. First of all, if any velocity See, u is the initial velocity vector. Okay, so I am drawing this u and it is at some angle theta with the x-axis or with the horizontal. So we will be needing ux component and uy component separately to solve all that equations of 2D. This is the example of motion in 2D. So how to get the components? So we will take the help of resolution of a vector that we have already understood. Okay, whatever is the projection of u in the x-axis that we call ux, and projection of u in the y-axis, or you can say shadow of u in the y-axis, that we call uy. And I think you remember that this x component, or the component with which theta is formed, that is u cos theta, and the second component is u sin theta. So remember the technique of resolution. So u, that means initial velocity, is bifurcated into two parts. Ux is u cos theta. Why u cos theta? Because theta is formed here. So this is base, and base is hypotenuse cos theta. Okay, hypotenuse is this u. That way we got u cos theta. In the same manner, this uy is actually perpendicular. Okay, this uy is perpendicular. Perpendicular is always hypotenuse into sine theta. So u sin theta. So remember now ux and ui values for the further solution. Okay, so ux is u cos theta and ui is u sin theta. Okay, now draw this diagram of the projectile, and now we are proceeding to the calculations of these different parameters. Okay, for the solution of these parameters we will be needing these four datas. Okay, so let us list down all the four datas here. As I have told you, in this case ux is u cos theta, uy is u sin theta. Okay, now let us discuss about acceleration. So as I have told you, in the case of the projectile, the acceleration is the earth's acceleration. That means the acceleration of any object is due to earth's attraction. So gravitational acceleration is present only, no other acceleration is there. So in which direction the gravitational acceleration works? So that is in vertical direction. So we will be having the ay value, because vertical direction means y direction. Now whenever any object is thrown upward, okay, this is upward case, then the acceleration we have to put minus g. Okay, so ay is now minus g. Remember this point. And do we have any acceleration due to Earth's gravity in the horizontal direction? No. So that means ax is zero. Okay, so these are the datas, these four datas. Using these four datas, we are going to calculate one by one these parameters. So we are starting with the first calculation, that is time of flight, which we denote by capital T. Okay, now for calculation of time of flight T, first of all we will be taking only half part of the journey, that means O to A. So we are mentioning here that we are using O to A. Now why we are using O to A? Because if we use this V equal to U plus AT equation, okay, to calculate the time, okay, V equal to U plus AT, because our target is to calculate the time. So final velocity, do we know? So yes, whenever any object is reaching the highest point, there the final velocity is zero. That's why this component we know. Okay, and initial velocities are already given to us in different directions. Okay, now we have to select that should we use this equation in x direction or should we use this equation in the y direction. Okay, vy equal to uy plus ay t also can be used. Now the idea is when this object is moving ahead at this vertical direction, at this highest point, the velocity vy component is zero, that we are sure. So we will be using this value. this equation we will be using. Vy we will put 0. That means now we are not going to use this way, the equation. Okay, so Vy equal to 0. Now Uy is u sin theta. Okay, Ay is minus g and small t. Okay, small t is what? We have taken only O to A part of the journey. So here time taken is capital T by 2. So we will be also using capital T by 2. Automatically from this equation, capital T answer will come, which is our need, which is the requirement. So let us solve it further. U sin theta is there only. G T by 2 is shifted here. So minus sign is removed. Now the target is to solve capital T. So 2 U sin theta upon G is the required answer. Okay, 2 U sin theta, 2 U sin theta upon G is the capital T answer. Capital T means time of flight. Okay, so you can see, thus students, total time of flight T, 2 U sin theta upon G. But if time of ascent or time of descent is asked, then it is T by 2. That means it will be only U sin theta by G. Okay, so we can notice it. We can note it down separately also. If time of ascent is asked to solve, then it will be only U sin theta by G. Okay, so time of ascent or descent is U sin theta by G. So total time of flight is 2U sin theta by G. Okay, now note down this time of flight case, and now we are proceeding to the other calculation. We have to solve horizontal range also, maximum height also, and some more parameter. Let us proceed. Okay, our second calculation is maximum height calculation. Okay, now how to solve maximum height, or how to get the formula for maximum height? So it is this way. Maximum height means this portion of the projectile. Okay, now when the object started from O point, then when it traveled from O to A, then it had obtained the maximum height. It has achieved the maximum height. That means we don't have to take the whole journey now of the projectile. Again, we have to take the journey from O to A only. Okay, so first of all, the journey is O to A, only the part of journey O to A we have to take for calculating maximum height H. Then, which direction equation we should use? Okay, so height means we have to calculate the displacement of the object. Okay, for displacement, either we can use S is equal to ut plus half a t square equation, or second equation is v square equal to u square plus 2as. Okay, both the equations are available for us. If we apply this equation, then we have to apply time. Here time square and here time. And if we apply this equation, then here we need, for calculating the displacement, we need the final velocity and initial velocity and acceleration. So second equation is easier to solve. So we are starting with the second equation, v square equal to u square plus 2as. Now we have to select the direction. Okay, direction means x direction or y direction. In which direction we should write this equation? So simply, because we want this height, we don't want this part, we want this height. That means we have to go in the y direction. So here every component we want of y direction only. All these are vectors. Okay, so this sy means displacement in y direction, that is h only. So this part is h. Okay, and all other values we are going to substitute so that we can calculate this h. Okay, first of all, in our journey from O to A, what is the final velocity at A and what is the initial velocity at O, that we have to substitute here, and only y component. So Vy, that means final velocity at A, is 0 because it has reached the highest point. Then Uy means jahan se start hua tha object, initial. यहाँ से स्टार्ट हुआ था, यू वाई इज यू साइन थीटा, लेट अस पुट हियर यू स्क्वेयर साइन स्क्वेयर थीटा बिकॉज इट इज स्क्वेयर नीडेड हियर. देन 2as, सो इन प्लेस ऑफ s आई हैव रिटन h, 2 इज देयर, व्हाट इज ay वैल्यू, माइनस g, सो दैट मीन्स हियर माइनस 2gh विल कम, ओके, बिकॉज एक्सेलरेशन इज माइनस g, ओके. नाउ आर टारगेट इज टू सॉल्व द हाइट, सो यू कैन सी वी हैव प्रिपेयर्ड अ इक्वेशन एंड वी कैन कैलकुलेट दिस हाइट, सो लेट अस स्टार्ट शिफ्टिंग. As we have shifted 2gh another side, it has become positive. Minus sign is removed. Now h, so 2g should be removed. So if I want to write the formula for So final answer of maximum height of the projectile is u square sin square theta upon 2g. Remember this formula for maximum height. Okay, so second parameter is salt. So only the thing is that you have to select first of all the part of the journey. Do you need to take the whole journey or only part of it? And then you have to select that y equation is needed or x direction equation is needed. Okay, note down the second case. Second part, now I am proceeding to calculation of horizontal range in the next sheet. Note down and proceed. Okay, let us calculate now horizontal range R. You can see in the diagram of projectile, projectile was thrown from here and after going to the highest point, it returned back to earth at B point. So what is the horizontal range covered by it? That is starting to ending displacement. Displacement between starting point and last point. So this is called horizontal range R. Okay. Now, first of all, which part of the journey we should take? So obviously, here from O to B, we have to take the whole journey. Then only this R will be calculated. So now the journey is O to B. Okay. Now, range is a displacement again. So for displacement, we have two equations again, either s is equal to ut plus half a t square or v square equal to u square plus 2as. Okay, now if I select the second equation, then u means initial velocity, that is given here. V means final velocity, final means here, but we don't know what is the final velocity of the projectile here. So v is not given. Okay, so we cannot calculate this displacement s. That's why we discard this equation now and we use this equation. S is equal to ut plus half a t square. Okay, let us start calculating. Now, if I use this equation, first of all, I have to apply the direction also in this. Okay. Now, should we select the x direction or y direction? So, it's very simple. We are not calculating now any vertical height. We are calculating the horizontal component. Okay, this horizontal range. So, that means this whole equation should be in x component. We don't put x component or x suffix with time because time is a scalar. Okay, now let us start. Our journey is O to B. So what is the O to B displacement? O to B horizontal displacement. It is R which we are calculating. Then what is UX? UX is U cos theta. Okay. Now what is time taken? So to reach from O to B, time taken is called time of flight, capital T. So we will call it just now. We will just now write it capital T and later we are going to substitute its value. Plus, okay, half of ax t square, but ax is 0. That's why this part of the equation is 0. So that means r is u cos theta into t. Now, only the thing is that we have to substitute this capital T formula which we have derived in the as a first parameter. So, capital T formula is 2u sin theta upon g. Okay, so finally u square and g, if I separate, u and u are appearing two times, so it will become u square upon g. Remaining things are 2 sin theta cos theta. Okay, and that is sin 2 theta formula. So for these students, I am writing this formula separately here. You can remember this sin 2 theta formula. It is 2 sin theta cos theta. You will be needing this formula in the numericals also. Learn this formula. Okay, so sin 2 theta is 2 sin theta cos theta. So here we were getting 2 sin theta cos theta. So overall it is written in short sin 2 theta. Okay, and sin 2 theta means it is not sin square theta. Okay, it is sin twice of theta. So this is the meaning, and we have calculated here the R formula, horizontal range formula. So u square sin 2 theta upon g is the final answer of horizontal range. Okay, now we have to further go to solve now the maximum range condition and angle of projection for maximum range case. So that I am going to explain you in the next sheet. Note down this case. Okay, so as a fourth parameter, we have angle of projection. We have to calculate at what angle of projection we should throw the projectile so that it covers the maximum horizontal range. This particular point is helpful for the sports students. See, it happens now that in the javelin throw, we should throw the projectile, that means javelin, so that it reaches the maximum at maximum distance from the throwing point. Okay, so we should know that what angle of projection helps us. So the idea is we'll take the help of this R formula which we have derived just now. Range formula is what? U square sin 2 theta upon g. Okay, now we have to make R maximum. Okay, R maximum. This range, when it will become maximum? So you see, range is depending upon u and g, and other than that theta also. Okay, so obviously this throwing velocity is important. Okay, this throwing velocity is important. But other than that, this sin 2 theta is also important. And you must be knowing that sin 2 theta's maximum value is 1. Okay, sin component or sin theta or sine angle does not exceed plus 1 and minus 1 value. Its value remains in between plus 1 and minus 1. So sine 2 theta's maximum value is 1. Okay, so if sine 2 theta is 1, so 1 means what? Sine 90. Okay, at what angle the sine component becomes 1? Sine angle becomes 1. So its sine 90 is 1. That's why if we equate both the sides, 2 theta is 90, so theta is 45 degree. So this 45 degree is that angle. So as theta comes 45 degree, that means this is the angle of projection for maximum horizontal range. If we throw the projectile at 45 degree with the horizontal, it is going to cover the maximum horizontal range. Now we have to calculate that maximum horizontal range formula also. So how do we calculate it? So it's simple. Sin 2 theta's maximum value we have substituted here. So sin 2 theta's maximum value is 1. So if I substitute it here, so it will remain only u square upon g. Okay, so whenever R max answer is asked, maximum horizontal range formula is asked, you have to write the formula u square upon g. So here we have calculated two things. Angle of projection for maximum range is 45 and maximum horizontal range formula is u square upon g. Okay, now note down this part. And now the last thing which is remaining that we have to solve under the projectile heading, that is we have to prove that this equation of trajectory or the path of the projectile is parabolic. So now we are proceeding to that part. Okay, so now our fifth part is that we have to prove that the path of the projectile is parabolic. Or the same question can also be asked in this manner, that solve the equation of trajectory or find the equation of trajectory. So how do we get it? Students, whenever path word is coming, that means you have to get the relation between y and x coordinate. Okay, if y is proportional to x coming, then it is a straight line path. And if y is proportional to x square, then it is a parabolic path. So we have to just get a relation between y and x. So that means we need to solve now x component, that means x displacement at any time, and y displacement. So it's simple. As we already know that x equation is solved by, at any time the x displacement is solved by uxt plus half of axt square, and y equation is also solved by uyt plus half of ayt square. Now only the thing is that we have to substitute these four datas in these two equations, and we have to merge the two equations. Let us start now. So ux is u cos theta t plus ax. Ax is 0. So this part is gone already. So this is a simplified equation. Now this side, y. Uy is u sin theta t half ay. Now you see ay is minus g. So I need to put here minus g value into t square. Okay. This way we have substituted these values in these two equations. Now as is the procedure which we have followed for the horizontal projectile case, that we have to merge the two equations. So what is the idea? We can calculate the time from any one equation and we can substitute it in the second equation. So if I calculate time, this time from this equation, it comes x upon u cos theta. Okay, so this time formula I have to now substitute in this y equation. Okay, so in this y equation, if I substitute the t answer, so u sin theta in place of t, the t value x upon u cos theta is substituted, minus half g as it is, t square means again x upon u cos theta, this t value, it's a square we have to do. After that, now whatever simplification can be done of this equation, that only we have to do. So let us complete now. So y will be what? U and u are cancelling, and sin theta upon cos theta is 10 theta. So x 10 theta. Okay, minus. Here also, let us see. All the constants, g, 2, u square, cos square, theta, written separately, and x square written separately. They are in multiplication only, but separately written. Now you can see that what should be the path of the projectile with the help of this equation. So this is that equation which we wanted. That means the relation between y and x is obtained. All other things are constant, like with what angle the projectile was thrown, that is a constant. G is a constant. With what velocity it was thrown, u is a constant. So how y and x will vary with respect to each other, that is shown by this equation. Now here y, in the y equation, x power 1 is also coming, x power 2 is also coming. But whenever two powers of x appear in the single equation, we have to always consider the bigger power, the dominating one. So bigger power is x square. That means we are getting y proportional to x square. Okay, we are getting y proportional to x square. And whenever y is proportional to x square, that means the path is parabolic. So this way we have proved the parabolic path of the projectile. And this way the theoretical part of the projectile is completed. Now in the next video we'll understand the numerical related to projectiles.